It was located in different malls, so we had activations inside those malls where we invite a lot of cyclists, a lot of all-goers, and even just passive cyclists to pass by and to have fun. But for more competing cyclists, the challenge was there. So we went, I think, around several different malls across Metro Manila and in Subic, to which we had our grand champion, yung knockout series in the Subic physical event. But definitely looking forward to 2021, 2022, and so on and so forth. We definitely have, once we are allowed to have physical challenges or physical distance rights, so we will look at integrating further virtual to get physical.
Right, that's exciting. I'm sure yung mga media natin interested talaga sila dahil ngayon dumadami na talaga yung mga virtual activities. And to hear that it's gonna be included in the next plans of GRU, that's really something to look forward to. Okay, so another question, Khalil, from Sir Anthony Cervinho of Bulbar. Will GRU run evolve into a real fun soon? So magkakaroon ba tayo ng parang running event with GRU? Ayan.
Oh, okay. Well, that's definitely something that we've actually been thinking about in prior years, right? Because we already plan enough days and enough races to close off some roads for the cycling event, and we think that, you know, running is a possible exercise or activity to have on the side, if not on the day after. So definitely we promote health. So cycling and running, you know, it is the best way of sports and best we can find that to promote it as well.
I think it's notable that majority of the entries in the virtual challenge has drawn a huge number of participants in the 1,000 kilometer ride.
Oh, okay. Because number one, the first virtual challenge, and we were at first thinking, you know, how long is it really acceptable for enthusiasts, competing professions to take on 1,000 kilometers? Right, so at first we were thinking, and of course we had to allocate some jerseys as prizes, we were thinking that, oh, maybe it would only take less than 500 people to do a 1,000-kilometer challenge. Of course, coming from data that we've got of physical events prior years, but this one is totally different. So we were actually it's notable for us because it's something that we didn't expect for us to get more than 1,000 cyclists to join the 1,000-kilometer challenge.
That's really nice. Actually, yun nga, parang the challenges of GRU is very holistic then. It's, meron tayong 50, may 30, tas meron tayong 1,000. Talagang pwede siya for anyone, even if you're a beginner or you're a professional cyclist, meron kang category na pwedeng salihan.
Yeah, so, and it's actually for aspiring cyclists as well, you know, kasi sometimes you don't know if you can take on 1,000, right? So it's something that it's, and given that this challenge is both attainable on outdoor and indoor cycling, it really is, you know, open for anybody. You're not super pressed. There's nobody pressuring you to finish the 1,000 kilometers. But if you can, it would have been great that ProRent would be able to provide you with that kind of thing.
Yeah, that's true. Actually, one of the many challenges I think that we can all agree on is that the quarantine and, of course, the tough times that we're facing right now, medyo mahirap kumanap ng time to relax and, you know, to bond with your family. But through this virtual online challenge, talaga namang we were given a chance to enjoy in a fun, yet safe and exciting way. Ayan. For ProRide, how has the digital pivot been for the group? How challenging and fulfilling is taking the event online?
Oh, wow. In terms of challenging, definitely, we've already gained more than 2,000 cyclists a few months away from our physical ride, last year, right? So definitely the challenge was to migrate them to join the virtual ride. And of course, taking care of that relationship, because that's something that we take care of and that we've felt pretty well from the past few races that we've had in prior years. Definitely the challenge of moving from physical events to digital events are what we say, very new to us. Because definitely we're always so used to, we're Filipinos, we like, you know, seeing each other, we like group events and enjoying things and enjoying wellness together. But definitely the fulfillment is there. You know, especially being able to provide, despite the pandemic, virtual races and rides are enabling you to also take care of yourself through cycling indoors as well. and it doesn't necessarily have to be at the time that we need to. It can be, of course, in the convenience of your own time and in your own pace. So that's definitely the fulfilling part from our end.
Yes, agree. That's totally true. Yun yung parang we're all given a chance to participate, be it in the comfort of our homes or anywhere that we like, while practicing social distancing at the same time. So cycling talaga is the perfect sport to practice or even just a fun activity to enjoy with your friends and family. Okay, since the first challenge is almost finished, how many virtual bike challenges are we looking at for 2021?
Actually, that's a really good question. For those that you guys may know, that it's Berlin UK's 25th year anniversary this 2021, more specifically on September. So without any that much finality, but because definitely we want to learn from the challenges we're experiencing in this first ever virtual challenge, we are looking at having our anniversary team by ProRide again sometime this year, maybe around September. We see weather is no longer a challenge for us because, you know, these things can be done indoor and outdoor. So definitely something for you, for us to look forward to this coming end of 2021.
Okay, that's really exciting to do. We have a question here regarding the Garmin units. Where can we buy the Garmin items?